Hi guys, if you want to increase the top speed of your scooter or to have better acceleration, you have to flash a custom firmware. And since the procedure is much simpler now compared to how it was when I made my last video on this topic, I decided to make a new video to show you how it's done. I'm going to use a classic M365 scooter which was updated to the latest available firmware, which currently is 171 for the motor, also known as DRV or ESC firmware, and 126 for the Bluetooth module. And the procedure is the same for the Pro scooter also. So even though I'm using an M365 Classic, you can use the same procedure for the Pro. By the way, please let me know in the comment section what scooter you have, Classic or Pro, so I know in the future for which one should I make more videos. Also, if you find this video to be useful, please give it a like and please subscribe to my channel. So let's start by checking the current firmware on my scooter. And let me record my screen because I will overlay the recording so you can better see what's happening here on the phone screen. So first, let's connect to the scooter using M365 tools to show you the current firmware. And as you can see here, the current firmware for the ESC, it's 171, the BLE it's 124, and BMS 126. The BMS doesn't matter. And in the past, before being able to flash a custom firmware for the ESC, you first had to flash an older firmware for the BLE, a firmware that was not encrypting the communication. But now this step is not needed anymore, so you can go directly to flash a custom firmware for the ESC. So let's disconnect from M365 tools. Let's open M365 down G. Here we click connect. We select the scooter from the list of Bluetooth devices. It connected. We wait for a second. Okay, so it now says to press the button on your scooter. You shortly press the power button on your scooter, just like when you're turning the headlight on. Actually, turn the headlight on. That's what you need to do. The app detects that the button was pressed, so it's paired okay with the scooter. At this point, we can go to a browser, browse to m365.scooterhacking.org, and here we'll create the custom firmware. I'm going to start from this preset and modify a few settings. If you have questions about these settings, please leave them in the comments and I will try to answer them as quickly as possible. So I'm fine with disabling cares. I'm fine. Actually, I'm not going to use this setting. I'm going to try this one. I like to reduce the motor start speed to 3 km/h, but I also like to reduce the cruise control delay to 3 seconds. I don't want to start in eco mode, and I want to use the Russian throttle algorithm. That's why I actually disabled this option, because using Russian throttle algorithm, it's going to ignore these parameters from here, the speed control parameters. Okay, I don't need this one. I also don't need this one. I don't care about this one. And I will modify the motor power constant, and this is the setting that is going to improve the acceleration. So it says to stay above 32,000. I'm going to use 37,000. Okay, and here we click patch. And when we click patch, The custom firmware is going to be downloaded on the phone. Now we can go back to M365 down G. We click on open bin. It says first check version, so we click on check version. Now we click on open bin, we go to the download folder and we select the file that was just downloaded, the custom firmware, and click flash. This process is going to take, I don't know, a minute or something like this. And at the end, that's all that we need to do to flash the custom firmware, right? I'm going to speed this process up, because there is no point in waiting for it to finish in real time. Okay, so as you can see, the process of flashing the custom firmware, it's almost ready. Actually, it's ready now. If we check version again, we will see that the DRV firmware version is 138 now. The BLE remained 124. So this is the difference compared to the old method. You don't need to downgrade the BLE anymore. Right, so this is all that you have to do to flash a custom firmware on your scooter. If you have questions, as I said, please leave them in the comments. And again, if you like this video, please give it a like. And also please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye.